So good evening everyone and welcome back once again to the series of government schemes. So in previous session guys, we have discussed the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana. I hope that scheme is clear. And in today's session, I will bring to you Pradhan Mantri Annadata Aay Sanrakshan Yojana. That's very easy scheme guys, bahut zyada easy scheme hai. Isme hum zyada time spend nahi karenge. Chote chote do teen components mein components hai isme that we will discuss. Okay, so let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information regarding the daily sessions. Okay, now let's talk about the scheme. And this scheme guys is completely effortless. Isme kuch bhi yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai. You just have to remember one thing, and that is the launch year. It was launched in the year 2018. Let me tell you this first. It was launched in the year 2018. This is the only thing that you have to remember here. Otherwise, if you are watching this session properly, then you do not have to learn, then you do not have to remember anything. This scheme is completely logical. Let me tell you how. So first of all, let's try to simplify the objective. What is the objective of this particular scheme? What is the name? Pradhan Mantri Annadata Aay Sanrakshan Abhiyan or Yojana, whatever you say. So Annadata means what? Farmers. Annadata means what? Farmers, of course. And Aay means what? Income. And Sanrakshan means what? Protection. Which means the government is providing income protection to the farmers under this scheme, which is known as PM Asha. Okay, I hope this is clear. The government is providing income protection to the farmers. Okay, and how the government can provide income protection? By procurement of the crops. By procurement of the crops. Okay, one thing. And another thing, by providing the remunerative prices to the farmers of their crops. By providing remunerative prices. By providing, you know, the jo bhi minimum prices hote hai, remunerative prices hote hai, wo provide karke. The government can protect the income of the farmers. So I hope the objective is clear. So under this scheme, what government is doing? The government is procuring the crops, or the government is providing MSP. The government is providing the difference between the MSP and the selling price. Wo aage aage hum chalenge to components mein hume samajh mein aayega. But the basic objective is to protect the income of farmers by procurement of the crops or by providing remunerative prices to the farmers. That's it. Okay, so I hope the objective is clear. Because guys, ab dekho yahan pe प्रोक्योरमेंट ऑफ क्रॉप्स की बात कैसे आई या रिम्यूनरेटिव प्राइसेस की बात कैसे आई उसकी बात करते हैं. सी द गवर्नमेंट वांट्स टू प्रोटेक्ट द इनकम ऑफ फार्मर्स एंड द फार्मर्स इनकम कैन ओनली बी प्रोटेक्टेड इफ ही और शी गेट्स द गुड प्राइसेस ऑफ हिज और हर क्रॉप्स. अगर उसके क्रॉप्स के उसको अच्छे दाम मिलेंगे तभी तो उसकी इनकम प्रोटेक्ट होगी. एंड क्रॉप्स के अच्छे दाम कैसे मिलेंगे? जब सरकार क्रॉप्स खरीदेगी या फिर उसको उसके क्रॉप्स का सही दाम मिलेगा. ओके, so I hope the objective is clear. And now ministry of course is the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, which is headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar. And remember, these days we are doing the schemes of Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, and then we will move ahead to other ministries also. Okay, baki jo ministries hai uski bhi hum baat karenge, so don't worry. Aur abhi time hai, exam mein kafi time hai, ek ded mahina bacha hua hai abhi, so don't worry. Sari schemes NABARD oriented jitni bhi schemes hai that I will cover. Moving ahead to the components. Okay, अब components की बात करते हैं. So there are three components under the scheme. And as I told you, there is only one thing that you have to remember here, which is the launch year. It was launched in the year 2018. Now let's talk about the components one by one. Number one is price support scheme. Price support scheme. Price support scheme नाम से ही पता चल रहा है, which means that some kind of support in terms of price is being provided by the government. Now this component guys is only for three crops. This component is only for three crops, which are pulses, oil seeds and copra. Pulses, oil seeds and copra. And what government is doing under this? So the government is procuring these three crops. The central government is procuring pulses, oil seeds and copra under this particular component of PM Asha. Okay, now central government प्रोक्योर कर रही है, इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट की कोई एजेंसी प्रोक्योर कर रही होगी, एंड दैट एजेंसी गाइस इज नाफेड एंड एफसीआई. द एजेंसीज व्हिच हैव द रिस्पांसिबिलिटी ऑफ प्रोक्योरिंग द क्रॉप्स इज नाफेड एंड एफसीआई. ऑलराइट, एंड द प्रोक्योरमेंट एक्सपेंडिचर एंड लॉसेज ड्यू टू प्रोक्योरमेंट विल बी बॉर्न बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. ठीक है, जो भी प्रोक्योरमेंट के एक्सपेंडिचर होंगे या अगर प्रोक्योरमेंट की वजह से कोई लॉस होता है, सो ऑल दैट एक्सपेंडिचर विल बी बॉर्न बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ओनली. ऑलराइट, सो आई होप गाइस दिस कंपोनेंट इज क्लियर. लेट मी रिपीट दिस. Price support scheme, government is procuring, the central agencies which are NAFED and FCI are procuring three crops, oilseeds, copra and pulses. ये तीन चीजों का procurement होगा and all the procurement expenditure and the losses due to procurement will be borne by the central government. Alright. Now moving ahead to another component which is known as price deficiency. Price deficiency payment scheme. So यहाँ पर price deficiency. You can see these two words, price deficiency, which means the government is providing the deficient price, the difference between the MSP and the actual selling price. Jo bhi difference hoga, wo kaun provide karayega? Central government. Okay. So under this scheme, remember, is only for oil seeds. This is for those oil seeds for which MSP is notified. Okay. Sirf oil seeds ke liye hai, jiske liye MSP notified hai. And State governments can either choose PSS or PDPS, which means price support scheme or price deficiency payment scheme. इन दोनों में से कोई एक ही choose कर सकती हैं state governments. And what happens under this scheme is the direct payment will be provided to the farmers. And what type of direct payment is this? This payment is the difference of MSP and the actual selling price. Difference between the MSP and the actual selling price is provided to the pre-registered farmers. Okay, which means there is no physical procurement under this. Component. कोई फिजिकल प्रोक्योरमेंट नहीं होगा, मतलब गवर्नमेंट ऑयल सीड्स प्रोक्योर नहीं कर रही है. द गवर्नमेंट इज सेइंग दैट ओके द फार्मर यू कैन गो एंड सेल योर प्रोडक्ट टू द मार्केट एंड इफ देयर विल बी अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन द एमएसपी एंड द सेलिंग प्राइस देन वी विल प्रोवाइड यू दैट डिफरेंस. ओके, सो आई होप गाइस दिस इज ऑल्सो क्लियर. प्राइस डेफिशिएंसी पेमेंट स्कीम, और उसके नाम से पता चल रहा है प्राइस डेफिशिएंसी पेमेंट, व्हिच मींस द गवर्नमेंट इज प्रोवाइडिंग द डेफिशिएंट प्राइस एंड दिस डेफिशिएंट प्राइस इज व्हाट the difference between MSP and the actual selling price. Okay, so moving ahead to the third component, which is private procurement and stockist scheme. Private procurement, naam se pata chal raha hai that some private companies will be hired, some private companies ko bulaya jayega aur unko bola jayega ki okay aap procurement kariye aur uske badle mein unko kuch incentive diya jayega, that's it. Okay, so isme kya hai, this component is also for oil seeds. Ye bhi kiske liye hai? Oil seeds ke liye. So remember, पहला कंपोनेंट वाज फॉर पल्सेस, ऑयल सीड्स एंड कोपरा. सेकंड कंपोनेंट पीडीपीएस वाज फॉर ऑयल सीड्स. नाउ दिस थर्ड कंपोनेंट इज आल्सो फॉर ऑयल सीड्स ओनली. सो स्टेट्स हैव द ऑप्शन टू रोल आउट पीपीएसएस इन सिलेक्टेड डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स इन द पायलट फेज. व्हेन इट वाज लॉन्च्ड इन द पायलट फेज, बट करंटली इट इज गोइंग ऑन. नाउ द सिलेक्टेड प्राइवेट एजेंसी शैल प्रोक्योर द कमोडिटी एट द एमएसपी इन द नोटिफाइड मार्केट्स. नोटिफाइड मार्केट्स में जाके द प्राइवेट एजेंसीज कैन, द सिलेक्टेड प्राइवेट एजेंसीज कैन प्रोक्योर the commodities, and commodities what? The oil seeds. And the maximum service charges up to 15% of the MSP is payable to that private agency. Jo private agency hogi usko kya milega? 15% ka maximum service charge milega. So you must be wondering ki private agency ka kya fayda hoga isme. So private agency ka guys fayda ye hoga that let us say there is a farmer and this is a private agency. So private agency is doing what? This private agency is procuring oil seeds from this farmer. Okay, so obviously this private agency will sell out these procured oil seed in the market or not? ये market में sell करेंगे. So of course, जब ये market में sell करेंगे तो इनको profit तो मिलेगा ही मिलेगा. So they are also getting some profit and 15% maximum service charge, 15% of the MSP maximum service charge is also being provided to the private service providers. Okay. So I hope this is also clear. And how you can remember this, this name private procurement, which means private companies procuring under this, and what they are procuring oil seeds, and what they are getting 15% of the MSP maximum service charge. Okay. So I hope guys this component is also clear. Now itna hi padhna is scheme mein. Let's do it once again. Pradhan Mantri Annadata Aay Sanrakshan Abhiyan, which means the government is providing income protection to the farmers. And the income can be protected only by procurement of the crops or by providing remunerative prices to the farmers for their crops. Then it is being implemented by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, which is headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar. And these are the three components. Number one is PSS, price support scheme. This is for three crops, oil seeds, copra. and pulses. And under this, NAFED and FCI are procuring the crops. And जो भी इसका खर्चा होता है procurement का expenditure and the losses due to procurement will be borne by the central government. Price deficiency payment scheme, it is only for the oil seeds. And under this, what happens is that the government is providing the difference between the MSP and the actual selling price to the pre-registered farmers. Okay, and which means there was no physical procurement under that component. Then we have private procurement and stockist scheme, which says that the selected private agencies, the private agencies will be selected for procurement of the oil seeds. Ye bhi sirf oil seeds ke liye hai. And also they will get 15% of the MSP maximum service charge by the government. All right. So I hope guys the component and the scheme is clear. Now let's talk about the questions that can be asked. Which of the following two agencies have the responsibility of implementing price support scheme component of PM ASHA? So price support scheme was what? Under which the government is procuring, the central agencies are procuring the three crops. And which are these central agencies? These are NAFED and FCI, which means 1 and 4 should be the correct answer. Option E. Option E, 1 and 4 guys would be the correct answer to this question. Moving ahead to question number 2. How much percent of MSP is payable to the private agencies as maximum service charge under private procurement and stockist scheme? So this percentage guys is how much? 15%. Very easy question. Is scheme mein se question aaya to bahut easy hoga because it is very easy scheme. And moving ahead to another component, which of the following crops are being procured under price support scheme of the PM ASHA? So this was the first component, and as we have discussed that there are three crops which are being procured, which are pulses, oil seeds and copra, which means 1, 3 and 4 should be the correct answer. Option A. Option A is the correct answer guys. I hope this question is clear. Only 1, 3 and 4, because pulses, oil seeds and copra are being procured under PSS. So I hope guys this question is clear, and that's it for the session. I hope this scheme is clear. In tomorrow session, I will bring to you two schemes, Sahakar 22 and one another scheme which is related to Sahakar cooperatives only. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Goodbye, take care and God bless.